Welcome to Intermediate Macroeconomics. I'm Dr. Dangerous Dave, and it's time to look at aggregate supply shocks. In the Myth of Macro video, we looked at how aggregating, that is adding up the demand curves for all the goods and services, can be used to arrive at the aggregate demand, or AD, curve for the entire national macroeconomy, and that adding up all the supply curves can be used to arrive at the aggregate supply, or AS, curve. In the aggregate demand shock video, we developed an ASAD model with a downward sloping AD curve, a vertical long-run aggregate supply, or LRAS, curve, and a horizontal short-run aggregate supply, or SRAS, curve. Be sure to review the aggregate demand shock video if you don't recall why LRAS is vertical or SRAS is horizontal. In the aggregate demand shock video, we also looked at positive and negative demand shocks. Now we're going to look at positive and negative supply shocks. To be honest, positive supply shocks are a bit of a museum piece, but negative supply shocks are a fact of life in our energy-intensive global economy. The most frequently cited example is the series of rapid increases in oil prices in the 1970s. The Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, is a cartel of petroleum-rich countries, primarily in the Middle East. As part of a broader political agenda, OPEC increased oil prices by 11% in 1973 and followed this with a crippling 68% increase in 1974. The trend continued, even if a bit diminished, through 1977. Here's an ASAD model of this. While this was a big price increase in the market for a single good, that good, oil, affected every other market. We portray this as a universal increase in aggregate price by shifting the SRAS curve upward. In reality, however, wages did not keep up with prices, which was part of the problem. Price inflation without wage inflation. The other part of the problem was the reduction in output from Y bar to Y1. This resulted in a big increase in unemployment from 4.9% in 1973 to 8.5% unemployment in 1975. The repeated shocks in 1974 through 1977 prevented the economy from recovering, so the economy couldn't budge off lower output and higher unemployment. This situation, a stagnant economy with high inflation, was given the portmanteau name stagflation. Here's the negative supply shock timeline. A sudden increase in AP, which shifts the SRAS curve up. The economy moves upward along the AD curve to lower output, Y1, and higher prices, AP1. Lower quantity demanded causes firms to move to lower cost factors. Factor cost reduction results in lower employment. Unemployed households spend less. AP starts unsticking. Firms lower their prices to reduce excess inventory, and the economy starts to move right along the AD curve. The economy eventually returns to normal output at Y bar. In the 1970s, however, the cycle kept going from time step 1 to time step 4, then back to time step 1 each time OPEC increased oil prices. That is, it never came back down to AP0 and Y bar. Otherwise, it would look like this. In reality, many of the events that accompany a negative demand shock would also occur with a negative supply shock. Households and firms would pull back, shifting the aggregate demand curve left. Lower factor costs would further shift AD left. Increased unemployment would shift AD left. High inflation, however, would cause households and firms to accelerate purchases, shifting the AD curve a bit to the right. So for this model, we'll just leave the AD curve unchanged. What happens with a positive supply shock? Well, the opposite mostly. Short-run aggregate supply shifts to lower prices overall, higher output at Y1, and here's the timeline. A sudden decrease in AP shifts the SRAS curve down. The economy moves rightward along the AD curve to higher output at Y2. Higher quantity demanded incurs higher factor costs. Factor cost increases result in lower unemployment, that is, wage competition. AP starts unsticking. Increased factor costs and lower unemployment drive AP back up. The economy eventually returns to normal output at Y bar. This is what might have happened with the natural gas glut in the United States that started in 2008, if not for the recession that started at the same time. Otherwise, the burst of natural gas made available by widespread fracking from 2008 to 2015 may have resulted in a boom era for the United States economy.